We have Srinivas Rao Raburi, Chief Investment Officer, Equities at PGIM Mutual Fund, now joining us. Srinivas, good afternoon. Thanks for joining us. Tell me, what's the market strategy in a market like this, which is going through a fresh round of uncertainty? Till about 1 month back, it looked like COVID was out of the way, and now it's made a strong comeback. How should portfolio investors approach this market now?
Definitely need to approach this with a caution. I think that is what I've been saying for some time. On one hand, we've seen markets moving up very sharply in the last many months on the expectation that A, the COVID is now history, and B, that growth will come back strongly. Whereas, as can be seen, COVID is again bad, so one need to be worried. And this along with the fact that valuations are no longer attractive or compelling, and then tomorrow there can be question on growth. You know, if you see Anuj, FY22 Nifty earnings growth estimate consensus something like is almost 40%. Even today it is closer to 37%. In the history, we've rarely seen this kind of earnings growth actually happening. So today there is rightly a question mark on this kind of a growth, and that's the reason why I think we are seeing correction. This kind of a correction is definitely warranted. So I'm very bullish on the medium term outlook, but I think the way markets have run up in the recent past, I'll be happy to see a correction.
Okay. Srinivas, good afternoon. No, that's exactly the point that we were discussing, whether this correction, given that today was that one way swift move, whether the bulk of it has already played out and now perhaps we get into a time correction phase, or whether you expect to see stock prices come off a little more to factor in a month lockdown or a 3 week lockdown in a state like Maharashtra.
So Surbhi, given the way cases have spiked in recent days, I don't think we will see a sudden drop in cases in a matter of 1-2 days. It'll take some time is what my view is. Similarly, market also would like to wait for clarity to emerge on the COVID front. And meanwhile, wherever stocks have rallied a lot, wherever there have been excesses, whether it is the stock prices of the listed companies, and we've seen similar excesses in the IPO market as well. I think both needs to correct and rationality has to set in.
Okay, sorry, I lost you there in between. Srinivas, you have a lot of auto and auto ancillaries in your portfolio, especially the mid-cap opportunity fund. Are you sensing some kind of headwinds now in this whole auto rally?
Anuj, there could be a short-term blip. I think the stocks that we have in our portfolio are not based on what is going to happen in a 1 month or one quarter. We are seeing that structurally auto sector will do well, and we are looking at stocks that will benefit from this, not on a 1 or 2 quarter basis, but on, let's say, I would say 1 to 3 year basis. So there is no need to revisit the whole hypothesis. But if you actually notice our portfolios, we've kind of booked profits in some cases where we thought that stock prices have already rallied a lot. So the overall hypothesis remains positive on auto, but again, it's a play of valuation. So I think wherever we see things getting ahead of times, we need to book profits. I think that's what we've been doing.
Okay. So Srinivas, since you do seem to be sounding sort of fairly cautious given the environment, let me ask you about the whole pharma trade. Now, last year, it turned out to be the darling sector. Could that repeat for the next perhaps couple of months, or do you think that the best of the pharma rallies perhaps behind us, and then it could be very, very stock specific from here on?
So, first of all, I don't think anybody can predict about what will happen in 2 months' time. On pharma, we remain positive and constructive on pharma space for 3-4 reasons. Expecting the kind of rally that we saw last year is, I think, it a bit unrealistic, given the fact that last year valuations are on your side. Now, after this rally that we saw, I don't think valuations are that compelling today in pharma sectors. It will be more stock specific. So I think opportunities are clearly there. Pharma as a sector, we remain positive, but I think one need to tone down the expectation in terms of what kind of returns one expects from pharma sector going forward.
Okay, Srinivas, this second wave of COVID, do you think it's a bit of a death knell for entertainment stocks like PVR or the restaurant stocks, the eating out stocks, or you think this is going to present another buying opportunity?
So, Anuj, we are negative on the sector that you mentioned. I think these sectors, will have maximum impact of COVID. And also, I don't think even if tomorrow lockdowns are lifted, this demand for this will come back with vengeance anytime soon. So, I'm worried on the demand front. And equally important, Anuj, if you see the valuations of these stocks in terms of, simple, like continue to use the same old barometer or metric of price to earnings. When I see the price to earnings, whether it is 1 year forward, stocks in this sector are fairly expensive. And actually, that is what makes me uncomfortable on this space.
Okay, so Srinivas, then finally, I mean, what would your best pecking order be till we know how the second wave really plays out? What would be your go-to sectors then in terms of order of priority?
So, in terms of sectors where we've been overweight, one is clearly the IT, the software sector. I think that's a clear beneficiary of both digitization, work from home, etc., and also companies benefiting from global opportunity, not just opportunity in India. The second bit that we have right now, if you see, is the industrials or capital goods. So, though we are cautious on the kind of growth that one expects, but we think that things will be better for the industrial space going forward. We are not saying that we'll see a big bang CapEx recovery, but compared to where things are, things will see a gradual improvement. And that's the other sector that we are positive. The third sector that we like is pharma. And pharma and chemicals, if I want to put these two together. So these are the sectors that we are positive on, where I'm saying we follow this growth at reasonable price philosophy. So where I have visibility on growth, at the same time, I'm not paying too much for that growth that I can see. So I think this is what would pay over a period of time, and we are betting on these sectors, Surabhi.
All right. Okay, Srinivas, good talking to you today. Thank you very much for joining in. You take care, stay safe, and we will look forward to our next conversation. Well, with that, let's just turn our eye back to the screen.